Hello, ladies and everyone who's joining me live. Thank you so much for joining. Happy Valentine's Day. I hope you're doing something special. I hope your partner, unlike my husband, who did not even really realize that it's Valentine's Day, is maybe paying a little bit more attention and you're treated with lots of love and even more so self-love. So whether you're celebrating or not, the topic of conversation that I wanted to chat and share with you about is all about sex drive. And specifically from the female's perspective, because we in our practice and our center, and for those who haven't, you know, maybe been following me for a while or don't know who I am, I'm Dr. Ina Lakshan, the founder of the Hormone Rebalance Center. We see a lot of women that struggle with a whole lot of hormone problems, but one really common one being declining sex drive. It's actually not a very easy concern to tackle, unlike things like hot flashes or night sweats, because there's so many factors that could be causing it. So I first wanted to share a little bit about what common causes could be driving it and what interventions can you take to try and improve it, okay? So first of all, your menstrual cycle. It's very common for women to fluctuate with their sex drive around their menstrual cycle. Naturally, after you have your period and it's done at around day 7 to 14 is typically when women's sex drive begins to increase because estrogen is starting to climb up. This is a really common time when women are feeling their best typically. They have the least amount of symptoms, they're feeling well, they're feeling sexy, and this is a good time where they're, you know, their sex drive is thriving. And then after ovulation, it can start to decline simply because of the hormonal changes. So your cycle alone, it's very natural, very normal to be experiencing fluctuations. Stress and poor sleep. So nothing kills sex like stress. For those of you who, you know, have experienced that post-baby time period, lots of work period, like women especially, we're not able to come home and just shut off our brain from our stressful day and, you know, just move on and go have sex. We are like still thinking in it. We probably don't even want to be touched or be, you know, do anything with it. So, you know, the stress, it can really, really kill sex drive. It's one of the reasons why one of the main interventions when it comes to improving sex drive is making sure you work on your stress response and cortisol. So I'll talk about that in a little bit. Other things are actual general hormone decline that happens as you age. So it is very common for us to see women who are 40, 45 and over experience low libido because their estrogen and testosterone are beginning to decline. So there's no doubt that there's an actual correlation with hormones declining as you age to, you know, playing a factor and a role in this. There's also physical reasons. So you may be experiencing discomfort, pain, maybe vaginal dryness, low lubrication. So maybe you do have the desire, no issues there, but when you get to it, it just simply feels uncomfortable. Some women may have something like polyps. So again, that is related to decline in estrogen. But it's definitely something that needs to be corrected and can be worked on, and there's lots of intervention to help correct vaginal dryness. I can probably do a whole video just on that alone. And then you also want to consider mental, emotional. I mean, of course, I'm coming from the assumption that you like your partner, but there's no doubt that with, you know, if you're experiencing any relationship issues or you generally are in a place where you don't really feel good about yourself or about your body, or maybe you've gained a little bit of weight and you just don't feel comfortable, that can really take a toll on your sex life and could have nothing to do with your partner. It could be you as well. So these are all possible reasons that you know that could be driving low libido. When we work on low libido with women, we want to almost look at every piece of the puzzle, because it's not usually just one factor that will that will be the cause. We kind of want to assess what is going on. Is it hormonal? Is it also stress, which is hormonal? Are we talking about low estrogen, low testosterone, or both? Are we talking about actual physical changes that are occurring in the vaginal area, and are we talking about mental, emotional concerns that are going a little bit deeper that are impacting, you know, your sex life as a product? So one of the best ways to actually know what is going on is to do proper testing. You probably know we're really big on testing. We love using dried urine testing that looks at estrogen, progesterone, testosterone, cortisol, and gives you a really good glimpse, as well as neurotransmitters, mood markers, that gives you a glimpse of all these things combined it's just really comprehensive. So that's one intervention. And otherwise, let's talk a little bit about what can you do, what can you take. As always, I like to say, don't go self-prescribe. And also, anything I may recommend to you doesn't necessarily mean you need to go and try everything. You still want to speak to your healthcare provider if this is the right option. But a few common things that have been shown to help sex drive are, number one, tribulus. Okay, so tribulus is a common botanical that can be given to both men and women. And it's funny to see how sometimes we give it to the women and their husbands keep coming back to buy it. So it's really funny. We have this inside joke in the office with our patients of how they're sending their husbands to go buy tribulus for them, because the husbands quite clearly noticed that it has increased the female sex drive. I hope I didn't get cut off for too long. There's just a call coming in. So tribulus can be given and taken by both men and women. And one of the ways that it works is by increasing androgen receptors in the brain. And although it hasn't actually been shown to truly increase testosterone to the level of, you know, something that a bodybuilder may want to use, but where, you know, it certainly does increase androgen receptors in the brain and has been shown to increase desire and as well as help boost your testosterone and androgen levels if that is the issue. Okay, also really good for stamina. So we actually use tribulus a lot when someone has both cortisol issues and low testosterone issues. Another intervention, and I've talked a lot about it, is maca. Maca is just one of my all-time favorites, because maca also is very supportive of your adrenals and your stress response, but it's also quite effective for increasing sex drive, libido, and just really generally like sexual desire. Stress response and adrenal support. So doing anything for your adrenals, being it simply focusing on adrenal support, we do notice with a lot of our patients, even if we do nothing to really support their testosterone, if we do really good job supporting their stress response, their adrenal glands, certain vitamins, minerals, certain botanicals, maca sometimes being one of them, tribulus sometimes being one of them, so kind of these are overlapping categories, patients do report that their sex drive improves. Hormone replacement. So some women, you know, I know that it's a scary subject for some. It alone could be a video in and of itself, but hormone replacement, if you're actually producing less than what you should be producing for your age, your hormone production is actually low, you do want to consider bioidentical natural hormone replacement, because I always tell patients, you know, you want to look at hormones like vitamins. You know, if do you want to just accept that it's okay to have vitamin deficiencies, or would you want to replace them, you know? So same with hormones. Of course, it's all about the correct levels, making sure it's the right dosing. It's an individual choice, but with hormones, you know, the risk of having low hormones could be just as dangerous as excess hormones, because we have hormones that protect us from aging too quickly, for brain health, for cardiovascular health. We want a nice good balance, and having too low estrogen or testosterone for that matter, one of the side effects of which is low libido, in and of itself is not a healthy state. So there's a few you know, considerations for hormone replacement. Exercise. Exercise is probably one of the best ways to naturally boost your testosterone levels. And it's interesting because we've seen testing with women who've had hysterectomies and also their ovaries removed. And if we've done testing with them and we see that they have very low levels, as we've expected, of estrogen and progesterone, but yet testosterone was actually nice and high because some of these patients were, they would exercise regularly. So it was really neat to see that despite doing testing, you know, on some women where we expected really low hormone production because they no longer have ovaries, their testosterone was actually really robust. And one of the reasons that we've attributed that is because those specific patients would exercise frequently, and you know, it would be part of their lifestyle. So there's no doubt that exercise can also help mental emotional state. Your stress response in and of itself is a great intervention for health in general, but it can also very much help your, not only how good you feel in your skin, make you feel more sexy about yourself, and also generally increase the desire. And let's talk a little bit about some foods that you can introduce in your diet. So, for example, some foods that are high on zinc, like oysters, are known to be a really common aphrodisiac. Other things that you're probably going to really enjoy me saying are a little bit of wine and dark chocolate. So if you want to tell your man a good gift for Valentine's Day is a nice bottle of wine with some dark chocolate, and you should be right in the mood to have fun. Of course, we're not talking about excess alcohol, because that can actually deplete and you know, your sex drive and make you more tired. But one glass or so of wine can really help calm you down a little bit, make you more in the mood. Dark chocolate, like I mentioned, other things like saffron have been shown to increase sex drive, and like I mentioned, things with zinc like oysters. So I hope you enjoyed this conversation. Let me know, you know, if there's any questions. I'd love to share more information with you. Just as a quick sort of summary and recap, when it comes to women's sex drive, it's not so black or white. It's not, you know, we don't have this on and off switch button that men tend to have, where a lot more, you know, there's a lot more factors that play a role for us. Like, it's harder for women to, you know, disconnect their mind from their physical body. And, you know, if they're under a lot of stress, if they're not doing well mentally, emotionally, their sex drive will suffer. So we, you know, with regards to tackling that, you gotta take several angles here, and you gotta truly understand what is playing a role for you. If it is the vaginal dryness, decrease in lubrication, things like that, those are physical issues that there are corrections for. If it's general decline in hormones, just a combination of high stress, you're in kind of this perimenopausal, menopausal phase where hormones are already declining, there's several interventions that you will likely need to put in place to support that. So again, if you have any questions, I'd love to share my knowledge, and thank you for joining me live and taking the time to be here. I hope you found some of this helpful and it gave you some clarity. And also, just do know that it is a really, really common concern. You know, young women, older women, and by the way, I also didn't mention certain side effects, like the birth control pill is notoriously known for one of its side effects having lower sex drive. So it's not just you, don't internalize the cause necessarily. Like, we want to understand what is going on in your body that could be contributing to these symptoms, because it likely has, you know, plethora of interventions that we can use to help support you. Okay, if you have any questions, I've provided a link where you can chat with us directly if you want to ask more questions about your specific case, and speak to our office assistant Isra. There's a link, you can chat with us directly. Okay, otherwise we will be coming up, and in this upcoming week I'll be sharing a lot of other tips for increasing sex drive that are more specific to some of the interventions I discussed. And as usual, we'll be releasing a blog post typically within about a week that captures all of this information. I hope you ladies, and if there are any men watching, have a wonderful, fun Valentine's Day, and I really appreciate you taking the time to be here with me. Bye for now.